Thank you. the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Every feast and every commemoration of the liturgical year has a Eucharistic character. But the Feast of the Ascension of the Lord has it in abundance. The first sign of this we find is in the fact that, in line with the scriptures, we celebrate this feast 40 days after Easter Sunday. This means that it is always kept on a Thursday, the day most closely associated with the institution of the Most Holy Eucharist and the Sacred Priesthood. The Thursday of Holy Week, Maundy Thursday, mystically and liturgically resounds in our celebration tonight, much as it will again in a few weeks' time when, please God, we will gather together to celebrate the Feast of Corpus Christi. If it is a Eucharistic feast, the Ascension is, secondly, just as much a priestly one. Taking the connection with Maundy Thursday just a step further, the act of the Lord's Ascension is a priestly act. The Epistle to the Hebrews puts it this way: "We have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God." The Lord has, in this feast, entered definitively into the sanctuary, into the Holy of Holies, where, as the liturgy puts it, he is the priest, the victim, and the altar of sacrifice. He has gone to enter, once and for all, into the heavenly temple, where he continually offers the eternal, once-for-all sacrifice of the cross. In doing this, the Lord does not leave us behind. Rather, Christ, the High Priest, the Good Shepherd, unites us to himself, gathers us into the fold, and takes us with him, truly leads the way to the place we hope one day to go. The priesthood of Jesus Christ, just like his offering, is not then something distant, something aloof, but something which, by virtue of our incorporation into his life in baptism, we too have become partakers in. Thirdly then, as the baptized mystically joined to Christ, we do not have to wait to participate in this priestly and Eucharistic offering. Instead, joined to his body, the Church, we can join here and now in the Church's worship on earth, worship which is a true foretaste and participation in the worship of heaven. In authentic Christian worship, we do not come and stand before God and offer our own man-made prayers. Instead, we join our very selves to the person and action and prayer of Christ, Christ who is the principal actor in the liturgy. And so we can come even now, even at this very altar, to the worship of the eternal Godhead, the worship offered by God the Son to God the Father, in and through God the Holy Spirit. In the offering of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, in time and space, we experience and benefit from the Lord's eternal sacrifice. The gates are flung open in the act of his ascension. The gates of the temple of heaven are wide open for us. As the psalmist says, "Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in." Finally, the heaven into which Christ, the great high priest, has on this feast gone is what Pope St. John Paul II called the cosmic realm that lies above the heavenly horizon, the earthly horizon. That is to say, the heaven of the Lord's ascension is the place of perfect openness to and before God. It is the place where the saints are privileged to behold God face to face. The ascension of the Lord then sees the humanity of Christ, which we share, enter into the realm of glory so that we might share also in his divinity. The ascension is the sign of divine transcendence par excellence, in that by it, our participation in the life of God is no longer something remote, but fully realized. In the midst of our ongoing difficulties and the distances we face from our presence at Mass, this understanding of our participation in the action and in the life of Christ, in the first place by virtue of our baptism, is, I hope, a comfort and solace. We pray, of course, for the day, may it come soon, when we can once again come to be present in the Church during the offering of the Eucharistic sacrifice. But in the meantime, we are reminded in this feast to know, truly, that we can be joined to that work, joined to the action of Christ and the action of the Church, and so come closer to him who, in his death, resurrection, and glorious ascension, shows that his own priority is to come closer also to us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.